Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to this webinar. Today is such an exciting day. Thank you for joining us. What a special day it is before our very eyes. Edible masterpieces will take form for us to relish, to savor. Let us begin our webinar as our guest has been so kind to accommodate us, considering that it is a weekend, it's a Sunday, and is preparing for lunch. And his reservation list is full. To start, allow me to introduce Senor Arusa. There are people fueled with passion, and Xavier Arusa is definitely one of them. Prior to COVID, may I ask everybody to kindly put themselves on mute? I will put their microphones on mute, please. There are people fueled with passion, and Xavier is definitely one of them. Prior to COVID, Xavier and I had grand plans of bringing Basque cuisine to the Philippines and the Philippines to the Basque country through Kitchens of the World, my culinary tours in partnership with Raja Travel. We all know what happened next. So till we fly again, Basque Fume and Kitchens of the World will take you to Spain, to the Basque country through our webinars. We have recently concluded our introduction to Basque cuisine and the evolution of the pinzo with Chef Paul Ibarra of Los Fueros, known for its local fare presented the contemporary way. Today, we will explore Basque cuisine from traditional to avant-garde. Today, allow me to introduce and welcome Xavier Arusa, who will bring us to the Basque country and let us educate us on Basque cuisine then and now. Xavier, mabuhay, where are you? Show yourself to us, please.
Hello, good morning. Can you listen to me?
Yes, we can hear you, Xavier.
Okay, so good morning, good afternoon there. It's a real pleasure to greet again Philippines from Bilbao, where I am now, here early in the morning. So as Reggie says, it's a real pleasure for us from Basqueum to connect. You know, Philippines and the Basque country historically has many roots. Gastronomy, I think, is a very good way of connecting again. So today I'm going to share my screen. Let's see if this is going on. Is going on well now?
Yes, we can see it.
So as Reyes says, the first session we made last month. We concentrate. I made like an overview of why the Basque Country is a world gourmet destination. So we spoke generally about the Basque Country, the gastronomy, wines, culture. But today we are going to concentrate in what you are seeing. That we are going to speak about gastronomy only. And it's from the tradition to this new Basque cuisine that it was a movement that started last century that changed completely the gastronomy in the Basque country. And we started being known all over the world. So let's start. And after that, sorry, as Reggie says, we will have the chance to see a video with our chef, a Michelin chef, Ander Unda, that is one of these young talent chefs that they are following the new Basque cuisine. And we are going to have the chance to see a Chacolí, our white Basque white wine pairing video also. No? So let's start with the presentation. I don't want to be very, very long, so then we will have time to make some questions. So I always like to start with a sentence. In this case, we choose Martin Berasategui, that is one of our most renowned, reputed chefs, Michelin chefs. As he said, the cuisine has not borders, but must have roots. So beside of cooking an excellent dish, it has to tell a story. And this sentence is comprising all what we want to explain today about this Basque new cuisine. So just for the people who don't know very well where we are, We are here in the map, in the nestled in this corner of Atlantic Europe, in the north of between northern Spain and south of France. So the Basque Country, eating and drinking is a luxury, and just very quick, because later we will have the chance to see. We have two restaurants among the 10 best restaurants in the world in the famous 50 best restaurants list. We have 23 restaurants Michelin stars with 32 stars in total. And if we consider the French Basque Country that we saw in the map before, there are even 10 more one Michelin restaurants in the area. So Basque gastronomy is an extraordinary and inimitable way of cooking and eating. So let's start from the tradition. The Basque Country has been the tradition of is what we could see in the last month's presentation. It's a very strong, deep roots in the cuisine in the Basque Country. So land and sea and land coexist on the stove of Basque homes. No, this combination is what gained a very diverse gastronomy as we have, because anyone who delves into the reality of Basque cuisine will find a diverse selection ranging from traditional and customary menus to haute cuisine tasting menus. And this Basque culinary range is closely linked to the decision taken by some chefs to seek out and rescue virtually forgotten recipes from traditional Basque cuisine. So these new ideas could flourish, and nowadays these techniques and recipes unprecedented to date are a reflection of the most exquisite culinary culture. No? Going on with the tradition, the flavor, which is the flavor of the Basque gastronomy. No? So we can say that it's a flavor of pots and pans, coal and wood, traditional Basque stoves and gastronomic associations. No? These are aromas of peas, artichokes, beans, mushrooms, anchovies, and of course the recurring porrusalda, Basque leek soup, that I recommend, suggest you to taste when you come. So you see, you can see all this tradition in every port, in every feast, every fresh produce market, sorry. So you can see all this combination, as we say, of land and sea that is converted in the traditional food, extraordinary food that I hope you will have the chance to taste soon. And from the tradition is we move to the pioneering. No? Basque cuisine incorporates both tradition and innovation. Tradition because of the respect shown to the techniques used by our ancestors, and innovation because of the regeneration of culinary processes and the improvement in raw ingredients. So currently, Basque Country is a territory which is open and modern, where it is possible to find gastronomic authenticity ranging from the most traditional to the most avant-garde. It is said that even if you go to the worst place in the Basque Country, you are going to eat well. So, but let's, and after this overview of the tradition and the flavors and what the Basque gastronomy is in essence, I'm going to explain briefly what is what we mentioned, the new Basque cuisine. This one was the big change of the gastronomy with the involvement of a group of Basque chefs in the late 70s. This movement was led by Juan Mari Arzak and Pedro Subijana, that probably they are familiar for you, are the ones, one of the most famous Basque chefs with 3 Michelin stars. And they, driven by the refusal of all these chefs to conform, they decided not only to recover the legacy received by way of a receipt book, but also to question the actual basis of the Basque cuisine. So all this happens. Yeah, you can see this young, when they were young men in the picture. So all this started in April of 76. When Arzak met Paul Bocuse, that probably you know, this French chef is one of the fathers of the recently, recently invented French Nouvelle Cuisine. So Arzak and Pedro Subijana, after meeting this man, Paul Bocuse, they decided to go to Lyon to visit him, and they started learning about what the concept of the French Nouvelle Cuisine. And they were like, say, okay, this was for them like the start of a new thing. No? And they have the opportunity, as you can see, to visit other famous chefs like Tourgrass brothers. So when after that trip, first gastronomic avant-garde movement was born within the country. No? They came back to the Basque Country and they say, okay, we are working with market products. We need the supply as well, but we could do something more for the Basque cuisine. So they decided to combine cuisine and culture and gather other chefs, not only two, and to make a team spirit and desire to revolutionize the receipt book of the moment. And you can see all in the picture below, these are all the chefs, they were involved in this movement in these late 70s. Some of them, they are very famous, like Carlos Arguignano, is actually a very famous TV presenter, or Luis Irizar, that is one of the most reputed cooking school in the Basque Country. But all this they made without breaking with the past. No? The chefs got it right by innovating whilst maintaining a great respect, dialogue, and attitude for the tradition and legacy. But these young restaurateurs from the new Basque cuisine had the great virtue of quickly joining a culinary revolution and of knowing how to adapt it to the Basque Country. But as you can imagine, now they are very famous, very reputed. But when they started, things were difficult because these guys, they changed completely the concept. So people look at them as some crazy men, like saying, okay, this we don't understand very well what they are doing. So they decided to organize a Monday dinner, changing from the restaurants of each chef, and just to invite the media, friends, and going to the neighborhoods and towns to make their purpose known. No? Nowadays, they have a very long waiting list in the restaurants, but at the beginning, it wasn't so easy. And their revolution was based, so we can say, in three principles: revision and recovery of lost dishes, ensuring the authenticity of the ingredients of the recipes in force, and the determination to innovate. And as Juan Mari Arzak, you can see here more actual picture, as he said, we wanted to change traditional dishes with local taste. We did not imitate Nouvelle Cuisine. We learned the technique for the French, but we put passion and enthusiasm into it. No? And this movement, what has been able is to reinvent the Basque cuisine, because this great trajectory of these pioneers has been enriched with the success and involvement of a new generation of chefs. Now, amongst them, we can mention, and probably you have heard about them, Andoni Luis Aduriz, Eneko Acha, José Analija, Álvaro Garrido. There are many. Ander Unda, obviously, that we are going to have the chance to listen to him later, our Surinia Garcia, without forgetting the unparalleled Victor Arginsonis, that probably you know, the king of the grill in his Echeverry restaurant. No? So this generation of young talents, they have not only joined the movement, which started during the late 20th century, but have also continued to research and innovate to position Basque cuisine as one of the leading reference on a world level. And all this revolution, the impact of that is that actually some of the Basque restaurants are considered among the best of the world. And starting with the list of the 50 best, the world 50 best restaurants, we have five, as we mentioned before, among the 50 best. Starting from the bottom, in the number 32 is Nerua, in the Astonishing Guggenheim Museum. So José Analija is the chef and is one of the we mentioned this young new generation chef, and he's doing very well in Bilbao, and actually is partner of Andoni Luis Aduriz that we are going to mention later. So when you visit the Guggenheim Museum, then you can enter this Nerua place that is worth in doing that. In the number 30, we have Elcano. Elcano we can consider like the temple of the grilled fish. Now you can see in the picture Jose and Arregui and Pedro, that is his son. No, the Pedro Arregui, he was the first, as you can see there, that roasted a whole turbot without removing the skin. And he started making, you know, from the very traditional grill, charcoal bass grill, he started innovating in that. So actually it's a pilgrimage for any foodie to taste the tradition of the charcoal grill. And the number 14 is Azurmendi with an Eco Hacha, you can see in the picture. This is another of the young leader chef of the Basque Country. And he has an astonishing restaurant complex in Larrabetxu near Bilbao. He's the 3 Michelin star also. And always betting for the sustainability, the local products. So it's an experience to visit his restaurants. And number 7 is Mugarit. From, we mentioned before, Andoni Luis Aduriz, probably he is the most rupturist and you know, innovative, creative chef in the Basque Country. So as he said, he admits that not all of his plates are designed to be enjoyed by dinners. So it's another, this is a big experience to go to his restaurants. No, it's always a You never know what you are going to eat. And the best classified in this list is Víctor Arginsonis. We mentioned before, this guy is now one of the most demanded restaurants in the Basque Country. It's a pilgrimage for all any foodie because he has like renovated. We mentioned before the tradition in the Elcano with the grill, and Víctor has invented, you can see in the picture, like different new system of grills, and in his restaurants, everything goes on the grill. So most of the plates are kissing of a smoke. No, even any dessert, any sweet, everything, even an ice cream is going on the grill and has this smoke flavor. So it's a really great experience too. And speaking about Michelin stars, I'm going quick with that. We have these 23 restaurants with 32 Michelin stars. We are going just to focus in the big ones. Like we mentioned before, Arzak in San Sebastian, it was the first Basque Michelin restaurant. He started in 1966 with his family. And he hosts 3 Michelin stars since 1989. So he's the second in Spain to get these 3 Michelin stars. And from this year, he's keeping year by year. And now you can see in the picture below, Elena Arzak is one of his daughters. Is I mean, the legacy of, and she is the one continuing with the restaurant. And we have to mention also, as the other father of the new cuisine, the Basque cuisine, is Pedro Subijana from Aquelarre, that he started in 1970 with this restaurant in the hillside of Mount Igeldo. And this guy has a big chance to get the 3 Michelin star because not only before the 2007, after 25 years with 2 Michelin stars. So he had to wait a long time to get the 3 stars. And now, apart from the restaurant, you can see below, it's in a spectacular complex of a hotel, luxury boutique hotel with astonishing terraces. You can see with a very nice view to the sea. So if you go to San Sebastian, this one is a must stop. Yeah, even if you don't go to the restaurant, at least to enjoy the terraces and the view. And the other 3 star in near San Sebastian is Martin Berasategui. that he, as you can see, he started very young in the world of the kitchen, in the kitchen world, sorry, only with 14 years. And at the age of 20, he took over his parents' restaurant. And he earned his first Michelin star only when he was 25. And since 2001, it has been awarded 3 Michelin stars. And actually, he's the chef with most Michelin stars, not only in the Basque Country, he's in Spain with 12 in the different restaurants he managed. And then the other 3-star Michelin star restaurants is Azurmendi, that we mentioned before with Eneko Acha, because by the way, he is the only 3-star restaurant that is also in the World 50 Best list. So we can see that the rankings are very different each other. And then 2-star restaurants, we have Mugaritz, that we mentioned, is the only 2-star restaurants we have with Andoni Luis Aduriz. And in 1-star, we have like 18. I'm not going to explain all of them because otherwise it would be very long. But we are going to stop at first in Boroa because he's going to be our main protagonist later when I finish. So this restaurant is an astonishing place because it occupies a 15th century farmhouse. It was completely restored and it's a, you know, amazing place to go. And they practice this modern style, a traditional menu with a modern style, no? Exploring what we mentioned at the beginning of the presentation, the roots of Basque gastronomy. So later on, we will have the chance to see that. And a similar restaurant in the conception of these Basque roots is Andra Mari from our friend Suriñe García, that, by the way, is our only lady Michelin chef if we or if we join with Elena Arzak, the daughter of Arzak, no? So if we have, we will invite Suriñe sometime also to these webinars. And it occupies, similar to Boroa also, a old farmhouse with very nice views. And then, just to mention very quick, these are the rest of the 1 Michelin star restaurants. Near in the area of San Sebastian, we have Suberoa, Alameda, Amelia, this Mirador de Ulia, with astonishing views to the San Sebastian Bay. You can see there El Cano, that we mentioned before. He has 1 Michelin star also. Marqués de Riscal is the only one in the Rioja wine area. M.B. Garrote is one of the restaurants belong by Martín Berasategui, that it has 1-star. Cococha, that is all in San Sebastian also. And then we move to the Bilbao area. We have the Echevarri that we mentioned, Richard Argisonis, has 1 Michelin star. Eneko is another of the restaurants from Eneko Acha that has 1 Michelin star. Echanove in Bilbao, Sor Chico also in Bilbao. Hola Martín Berasategui is in Bilbao, but run by Martín Berasategui, so another Michelin star. Mina, Zárate, or Nerua. That Nerua we mentioned, you remember, is the one in the Guggenheim Museum. So even if you go to Bilbao or to San Sebastian, you can see you will find a very creative, nice, from traditional to the avant-garde. And just to finish is what I mentioned last month, no? Gastronomy and wines remains at the first most demanded motivation by leisure tourists visiting the Basque Country. And it's a percentage that rises to more than 50% for second visits. No? This one means that, as you can see, the Basque Country, we are very small in size, but in gastronomy, because of this is a gourmet destination, and we are very pleased to invite you when the borders are open to organize with Ray any foodie trip, any exposure visit to feel alive all what I am explaining. And with this one, I finish. So if you have any questions to make to me later, I would be very pleased to answer you. from Bascune. So thank you very much for listening to me. And I finish with that.
Thank you, Xavier. Yes, we will fly the minute we can. And we will eat all those beautiful restaurants as we planned. And now let us introduce our special guest. He's so kind to have said yes to us, considering how busy he is and how hectic things are right now in Spain. Chef Anderunda has been so kind to grace our webinar, and I am very excited. Proof that no pandemic can ever separate us from the love, from our love for food. Chef Ander is the chef of Baroa, a Michelin star restaurant in Vizcaya, Spain, that first opened its doors in 1997. Baroa is a small farmhouse from the 15th century and has managed to stay true to its original architecture. It is a magical place surrounded by century-old oak trees. Chef Ander became Baroa chef in 2015. He has worked with Michelin star chefs Hilario Arbeláez, Antonio Aduriz, Juan Maria Arza, Jose Analija, and Chef Paco Torreblanca. He has also worked as chef de cuisine at Hotel El Coto and Roca restaurant. Let's warmly welcome Chef Ander. Chef Ander.
Hi, everybody. Good afternoon. I'm very pleased to join with you. I have to thank Reggie very much for inviting us to this webinar.
And I hope that you are coming to Manila the minute you can fly, right? You will come and cook for
us. I want to. I'm deciding, but the situation is not so good. So I hope I will be there.
Yeah. So Chef Ander prepared beautiful dishes for us today. Tell us about the dishes that you prepared, Chef Ander.
I prepared three dishes. The first one is white prawns of Huelva. Huelva is a region of Spain that prawns have a special taste because they live far in the sea, very down, 2 or 3 kilometers down in the water. So they have that special taste and texture, and we make some techniques. We make a tile with its heads. We make with an egg yolk and a bit of potato cream, and more things to decorate and some flowers, and I think you will like it. That is the first one. The second one is an octopus that we have a very, very good quality octopus here in very near of here in Galicia. We put with a sauce a bit of soy, honey, garlic. We make a sauce we put in the octopus and we grill it, and that makes a very special taste to the octopus. We help it with potato textures. We make a mashed potato. We make a potato saffron with saffron. We dry potato. There are 3 or 4 textures of potatoes, and a black garlic cream. The black garlic is a garlic which is fermented, and it becomes black, and it loses the strength of that garlic, so it's soft and it's very, very nice taste. And the last one is an special egg. It's a glass made egg. That plate was made for a championship, a Spanish championship of pinchos, and it takes the prize of the innovation prize, the best pincho in innovation area. So I think you will enjoy, and It's a pity that we can't taste them, but bueno, at least see them, and you everybody are invited to Boroa restaurant in near Bilbao to come to Basque Country and enjoy yourselves.
So we can now begin our video, Xavier.